Okay, back in the basement. That's pretty great, actually. And look, the golden gate is back up. I've had quite a week. You know, it was last Thursday, you know, it was in the Bragernes Church. It was great. Yeah, look a bit small. Yeah, no, that works. It's fine. I was in Bragernes Church talking to the priest. It was great and I felt great. But then, you know, the sneaking feeling of failure came like creeping up on me. Like, is this really working? Is this, am I doing it right? Is it going the way it's supposed to? Overthinking, I believe, is the term. I got a bit lost. This has happened before. This is not the first time, is it, Markus, that I've gotten lost? I get lost quite frequently, actually. I wonder if that's part of the human condition. Maybe that's something we'll talk about on the show tonight. Who knows? That hasn't happened yet. But I love doing this show, and you know, it's such a delight to every Thursday get to do this. And this fine evening, you know, I have a wonderful guest, this wonderful guy who I met at a wonderful place in the dream. And all of it is just so wonderful, and I feel super great. But a couple of days ago, felt super bad. Isn't it strange how we humans can be like, it's like a roller coaster, like you're all the way up here, you know, this is so great. And then it's like, down, and you're like, I'm dying, this is horrible. And then it sort of flatlines a bit and then goes up again. It's quite a ride. I enjoy it immensely. But at the same time, obviously horrified as everyone else, because I am human being. But in addition to being a human being, I am Wolf Thunder Flitty, I'm a talk show host, and this is the Wake Up Show. And I think it's about time that we run the intro.
Live from the dream, aka Drummond, it's the Wake Up Show with your host, Wolf Thunder Flitty.
Welcome to another episode of the Wake Up Show. I am Wolf Thunder Flitty, and I'm the host of the show. And I'm doing fine, by the way. Thanks for asking. But you know what could make my life even finer? It's this thing called Patreon.com/The Wake Up Show, where you can support the show and make the show a sustainable workplace for me, my buddy Markus over here, and you know, I can, I don't know, maybe exchange this cardboard cutout of the Golden Gate Bridge into the real Golden Gate Bridge, for instance. That would be pretty spectacular, and you cannot make that happen with Patreon. Another thing that's really great is that in the dream, here in the dream, there is this place that serves organic, vegan, non-refined sugar, delicious cacao. The place is called Criollo. I guess it's a Spanish name and means cacao bean or something like that. And they make this delicious cacao that I've put into my Wake Up Show cup to drink to celebrate the fact that there is something so delicious and sweet and wonderful here in the dream. And if you ever go there, you should ask for the Wake Up Show special, which is my special blend of wonderful cacao. Yes, it is delicious. Also, I've been watching Twin Peaks a lot lately, and you know the guy in Twin Peaks, he keeps sipping on coffee, and it's like, he just enjoys it so much. It's incredible, but I enjoy my cacao. And now, if you are so unfortunate as to not be living in the dream, there is ecochocolate.no, where you can order your chocolate products and, you know, make it yourself. That's pretty great, right? Yeah. In other news, I guess the world is as it has always been. There's a plague, there's a war in places of the world, and probably famine. There's also joy and laughter, death and birth, and all of the above. But, you know, a couple of weeks ago, at Criollo, actually, the place in the dream, I ran into this wonderful guy. Well, actually, I sat down next to him because he looked so interesting. And the owner of Criollo said, you have to talk to this guy, he's such a great guy. And I was like, a great guy? I love great guys. I want to talk to this great guy. So I went over and talked to him, and his name is Eirik, and he lives in the close to the dream in Holmestrand, and I invited him to the show, and he said, well, of course. Well, actually, he didn't say of course in the beginning. He was like, but then he called me and was like, yes, let's do it. And tonight is the night when Eirik has come with the train from Holmestrand here to the dream. Eirik, I want you to come into the studio. Come in and have a seat over here on the chair. Welcome to the show. Yes, you, Eirik, you. I know that he prefers to be called Eirik, but I have no idea how to say that in English, so thus I just...
You don't have to say it in English.
No, that's true.
That would be wrong. That would be wrong.
So wrong.
No.
In so many ways. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, my new friend.
Yes. Now, what's interesting about our new friendship is that the moment I sat down next to you at Criollo, the wonderful place in the dream, I was like, it feels like I've known this guy for centuries.
Maybe you have.
I dare say, let's just cut the maybe and say,
you see,
it's good seeing you again, man.
You come back to this planet again and again until you reached enlightenment. Enlightenment is the reason for being here. Enlightenment is being to be able to live the God in yourself.
You're just going right at it. I love this. Would you like some cacao, by the way?
Yes.
Yes, of course you would.
I would. I would die if I don't get any, seeing you.
You know, that would obviously, I don't know how that's for ratings, like my guest dying. Here, have a nice cup of Criollo cacao.
Yes.
But so, when I met you and wrote down your phone number, because you are old school and we talk on the phone together, which I love, I wrote karma and a heart. I that's what I wrote next to your name on my phone. It says like karma and the heart. And I don't know why that karma thing came up, but I was like, okay, we might as well just go with it. And I was wondering like, what is karma? And when I wonder about something, Eirik, you know what I like to do then?
Yeah.
I go out into the dream and I ask my fellow dreamers about the thing I'm wondering about. What is karma?
So basically it's like when you do something to like someone, you might get it back, or like, yeah, the world goes around, what goes around comes back around.
What goes around comes around, yeah.
When you do something good, you have good karma, maybe, or you do something bad, you have that bad karma with you, I think.
It could be something positive if you think about good karma.
Yeah.
Something about the person that is good, like, or it could be bad karma. So that's the other side.
And what happens with this karma?
I don't know, because.
Is someone keeping score or something?
No,
or
no.
Do you get a prize at the end?
No, I don't think.
Karma.
Yeah.
It's what happens to you. If you do good thing, you will get good things, and if you do bad stuff, you will get bad stuff.
Is it something you believe in?
Yeah.
It makes sense, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, in a way, because I can say that when you do good, I'm pretty sure like we believe that good is gonna come to us. And yeah, when you do evil, somewhere along the line, maybe you might get burnt.
It come back to
haunt you. So yeah. So in a way, but it can be scientifically proven though. So.
Jeg skulle egentlig vært og hentet min elektriske sykkel I dag, men det måtte jeg jo.
You have to speak in English, man. It's an international show. Huh? We're back on. Well, as you could tell, the Dreamers had many opinions about you getting a bicycle in Oslo today, which you didn't do because you came here instead, and I appreciate that.
Yeah.
And what dawns to me is like people in general in the dream think karma is sort of like, well, do good unto others and good things will happen to you.
That is more or less karma philosophy.
Yes.
But karma is nothing but you will reap as you sow.
Yeah.
The world cannot exist without karma because it means everything that happens is according to the laws of nature. Yes?
Yes.
There is no tilfeldighet.
Coincidence.
There's no coincidence. Only we do so many things we don't remember, we don't understand. But life is not a place where you reap whatever you get. So what people call bad karma doesn't really exist. Bad karma, no, all karma is good because you get what you're supposed to get.
You know, yeah. I like that,
yes.
Right?
Karma is that which you need to know when you do something wrong. That is bad karma. And if there had been no thing to reap, you would continue doing the wrong thing again and again.
You would go in circles.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Now, I guess the reason why I wrote karma next to your name is because when I met you, there was this good vibration, you know. There's something like, I felt very, for one thing, I felt like I was sitting down with a friend, like a good friend whom I'd known for a long time, like I said, and I felt at ease, and, you know, I felt like, it just felt lovely. And I guess it's strange, the whole like karmic thing is sort of like, it's as you say, it's part
it
of nature.
It explains so many things that you otherwise would not understand. And it makes you understand that when something bad happens to you, it's not, why should it happen to me? But it is always just. Karma is just. You get what you deserve.
Yeah. Or could you say you get what you need, not what you want?
Yeah.
If you what like, you can put your nice Criollo cup behind you on that speaker, or if you don't want to hold it in your hand. Or you can put it over here as well, if you like. Do you want to hold the cup or do you want the
cup? No, I can hold the cup.
You can hold the cup.
Yeah.
Is the cup half full or half empty?
Half empty.
Oh, that's horrible.
Gosh. You know, we are slotta nå, ikke sant?
No, we're still...
We're still on.
Why would we stop?
I don't know.
You said very many clever things, but we're not done yet. You know, this is why I make the show. It's called the Wake Up Show, you know?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I feel it's my obligation because I got this. You have to look at me. Don't look at the screen. Don't care about the screen. Doesn't matter. You and me. I got this. I had this dream.
Where
God, I had a dream.
Oh, yeah.
Where God came to me and said, you're going to make a talk show.
Oh, yes.
And I was like, well, sure. Who wouldn't want to make a talk show? So I did. And this is the show. And the show is called The Wake Up Show because I am playing my part in waking everyone up to the joy of human existence with all its bells, whistles, and flaws.
It is so necessary, so important what you are doing, because what is most important, wake up to the reality. Not all these stupid things you see on TV or what happens to you. Everything is part of bringing you forward. And if you, what you experience, and if you say no, it will take you long, 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 many lives.
Yeah, you just have to do it over and over and over again.
Over again, yes.
Ah, how many times have you been doing this? Have you been counting?
No one can tell you, and you can't tell yourself either.
No, it's great, right?
Yes, because if you lived so many years ago, maybe you was a soldier with Napoleon and did terrible things.
Yes.
If you remembered that, oh God, you would say.
Yeah, that'd be a tough load to bear, yes.
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 You might not be able to take it. You might even get sick, mentally sick.
Yes. But so, you know, they didn't teach me karma or enlightenment at school. Where did you find all this, how did you come across this this information? I wonder.
One day I got a letter from my brother, who's living in California.
Your Californian brother?
Yes. And he said to me, if there is a lecture on transcendental meditation in town, go and listen. So I did.
Transcendental meditation?
Yes.
Ooh.
And I did. And I immediately understood, this is what I'm going to do. I am going to start doing transcendental meditation. And if you gave me $1 million, I would not stop doing it. It's part of my life. It's not that I feel I have to do it every morning and every night. It's just an of course. It's an of course. I cannot get away from it. And I remember one thing Maharshi told once, Maharshi Mahesh Yogi, yes, said, when I came to California, once I went to San Francisco and gave a lecture. And late, the day after, in the newspaper, it said, Guru here to learn us to sleep. Make us to sleep. And he said, I came to wake them up.
They got it all wrong.
They got it all wrong.
Hmm.
So everyone can wake up.
Yes, everyone can.
Yes, everyone can. And if they do, life will become much easier. You get less sick and more happy and more healthy. Yes?
Yeah.
You can live the life you're supposed to live.
Not someone else's life.
No.
Your own life.
Yes, your own life.
Why do you think that it seems like a lot of people prefer to be sleeping? Is it because the bed is too comfortable?
Many people are unhappy.
Yes, yes.
Because they're not doing the right thing.
They're not doing the thing they came here to do, you know?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Life is supposed to be bliss. If your life is terrible, it's either karma or that you are making the wrong mistakes, yes, the wrong things.
You're walking in the wrong direction.
Yeah.
You're not following your path.
Right.
You're not listening to your heart.
Yeah, yes, yes, yes. You couldn't say it in a better way.
Hmm. But I guess if the majority of the human population is walking in the wrong direction with their eyes closed,
there'll be wars.
There will be it'll get messy.
It'll be very messy. There'll be a lot of wars, a lot of diseases, loss, a lot of hunger and all the negative things many have to
endure. Yeah.
Yeah.
But then again, you know, have you ever played video games, Eirik?
Never.
Never?
Never.
You didn't even play Super Mario?
Never.
Not with your kids, even?
Never.
Oh, well, then that's something.
You see?
That's something we need to do, man. Well, here's the thing. Now, what I was going to say about video games. You know, when you start the game.
Yeah.
It's typically levels.
Uh-huh.
So you start in the first level. It's easy. And you play the first level and you get to the end of the first level and then you level up.
But I played chess.
Yes, wonder if that... Yeah, maybe that works. You know, you start at the amateur level.
Mm.
It's not so hard. But the better
to
you get, the more...
chess is not difficult to be a good player. It's not easy.
But don't make this about chess. We're talking about video games. And I'm so surprised that you haven't played any. They've been around for a long time, man. You've missing
hundreds
out.
Hundreds of years, I believe.
Yes. At least. But what I was going to say is, so you level up. But here's the thing. For each level, the game gets harder. And harder. And harder. Up to a point where it's almost impossible. And you're trying, and you're dying, and you're trying, and you're dying. And maybe you give up, you know, you turn the game off, you take a break from the whole thing. But you come back again because you want
to
complete, you want to complete your mission. And Super Mario is a plumber, and he has to save a princess. That's the objective of the game. I've not played Super Mario. This is horrible. We shall play Super Mario one day, and I'm looking forward to it. You will enjoy this.
But you see, I have in no way a very average man.
No, you're extraordinary. Look at you. You're glowing over here.
And I do my asanas. You know asanas?
No.
Asanas means positions, meaning yoga.
Oh, yes. You're doing your yoga?
Yeah.
Your asanas?
Yes.
And you do your TM, or transcendental meditation?
Yes, I do.
Is that the one where you have a mantra?
Yes, we do.
But it's secret, right?
I'm not supposed to tell you my mantra, because it doesn't really mean anything to you.
No, it means something to you. But if I wanted to get my own transcendental meditation mantra, can I just make one up?
No.
Do I need...
I can give you one.
You can give me one!
I am a meditation teacher.
You are?
Yes.
This is your...
In the Oslo area, more than 700 people have learned TM from me.
Holy crap, man. That's great.
I am one of Norway's most experienced TM teachers.
You're the TM guy.
Yeah.
I knew there was something about you. And you're going to learn me my own mantra.
I have initiated ordinary people, but mainly intelligent people came to learn. And I have initiated professors. And they all think it is just wonderful. But quite a few stop after a while because they don't really know why what they're doing.
Oh, they don't want to quiet the mind.
Yes, they do. But
they don't want to be present.
We're so different, you know. Some people say, oh, I don't have time. I cannot do this. And then after having done it for some time, they said, I have more time now than I had before.
Yeah. It's strange, right? When you're stressing, you're like, there's not enough time.
Mm.
But when you calm down, there's like, oh, I can do this, I can do that. Behind you, there's like, yeah, just put it wherever you like. It's a basement, you know, it's fine.
Yes, you see... what you will get from meditation, I say TM, transcendental meditation, because it's so simple and it's so natural. And because it's natural and simple, it's working better than most other meditation forms.
I guess we humans tend to make things a lot more complicated than it needs to, right?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
And it's you need to do this. You need to have this type of clothing, and you have to have like this mat and this CD with music on it to get into the right mood.
Do you know, we all are different. Not two of us are the same. Everyone knows this. Everyone knows this. But they don't want to accept it, really.
No, we still would like everyone to fit through the same mold. Like,
yeah,
this is how it's supposed to be, and please fit into this box. It's strange. Mm. Everyone's different, but we all feel this need to, like, fit into the same box. It's interesting. I was going to finish my game thing.
Yes, please.
What I was thinking, the thing that came to me when I was sort of contemplating this was, we often have this idea that the sort of more advanced you get in your incarnations, like your lives, the easier it will get.
Yes, but then what is advanced?
Right. And also, what is easy?
Yeah, what is easy?
And
easy is being innocent.
Yes. Yes, naive.
Accept life as it is. Do the best you can in all kinds of experiences.
Do your best. I read this nice book once. It's called The Four Agreements. And the first one is, speak the truth.
Speak the truth.
Don't lie.
As you see it.
And be sort of, speak properly. Don't be rude.
Yeah,
speak
yeah,
the truth.
Yeah.
And then the other one was, what was the other one? It was something along the lines of, never assume anything. Because you don't know. So you start all these assumptions, right? Oh, yeah, it's probably because, and that's the explanation.
And
then you have this thing going.
We are the one we are. And we will make mistakes.
We will.
And if you're awake, you will say, oh, gosh, I made this mistake. I'll not do it again. And sometimes the mistakes are hiding.
Yes.
And you won't discover it.
Yeah, it keeps popping up.
Yeah.
Third one. Don't take anything personal. I love that one. It's good, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because you take things personal, it has nothing to do with you. People have all sorts of weird problems and they project it onto you. Yeah, for sure. But why would you take it personally? And then the fourth one is, of course, do your best. It's nice. So I'm doing my best at telling the truth, not assuming anything, and don't take anything personally.
Yes, but I still think, accept, that's very important, to accept that you're not perfect.
Oh my God, yeah, that's a good one. That's the fifth one. There should be a fifth one in the book. Have you ever written a book, sir?
No, sir.
It was very formal there. Interesting.
No, yes, sir. No, sir.
You know, this is so lovely having you here. Maybe I should... Should I play a song for you?
If you should. What?
I'm going to play a song for you, man. With my guitar. Yeah. I'm going to play a song.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, that guitar.
Yes. How are we on time? Because
my dreams is about singing in England.
Oh.
What is it? I have a program called... What's the program called again? There's a people who are not known.
Oh, like Britain's Got Talent.
Yes, Britain is a talent.
They have a show in Norway. Norway's Got Talent. You don't have to go to England. Or do you want to do something in English?
Perhaps? I didn't know Norway had it.
No, but you didn't even know Super Mario was a thing.
There's many things I don't know.
You know,
I don't care.
The more I learn, the less I know. Is that how it goes?
You're talking about yourself now.
Yeah, but of course I am.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about
it. Come on, play.
I'm going to play a song which I like. That makes sense, right? I remember when I lost my mind. There was something so pleasant about that place. Even your emotions had an echo in so much space. And when you're out there without care, yeah, I was out of touch. But it wasn't because I didn't know enough. I just knew too much. Does that make me crazy? Does that make me crazy? Does that make me crazy? Possibly. And I hope that you are having the time of your life. But think twice. That's my only advice. Come on now, who do you, who do you, who do you, who do you think you are? Ha ha ha, bless your soul. Really think you're in control? Well, I think you're crazy. I think you're crazy. I think you're crazy. Just like me. My heroes had the heart to lose their life out on the lane. And all I remember is thinking I want to be like them. Ever since I was little, ever since I was little, it looked like fun. And it's no coincidence I found. And I can die when I'm done. Maybe I'm crazy. Maybe you're crazy. Maybe we're crazy. Probably.
Fantastic.
The song is named Crazy. That's the name of the song.
Did you?
I heard it on the radio once.
Oh, you did?
Yes.
And you remember the whole song?
No, because I looked on the screen and it said the lyrics and the chords. I cheated death many times.
I once, a song came to me. I was not at all intending having a song or anything like that. And I never forgot it.
A song came to you?
Yeah.
Did you write it down?
No, it's in here.
Oh, it's in there. Yes. Is it a song that you can sing?
I could.
Are you going to?
I don't want it to be on the screen. It's a little bit naughty.
It's a naughty song, but this is late night TV. If you want to sing naughty song, you can, but if not? we will sing it after the show is finished, and they will not get to hear it.
Yes.
But I want to hear it. I'm looking forward to hearing that song.
It's maybe 10 years ago it happened.
It just happened.
It just came. Yeah, there were two different songs. One I have forgotten.
We should record it and, you know, release it or like make an album or something.
I have heard people have been asking me if they could have a song. And I said, I don't know. And someone would get a little bit annoyed, especially in America, because they have some kind of sexy... Well, it's a little bit sexy. Yeah, and they're so crazy over there.
Yeah, they're pretty, like, they're strange. The Americans are kind of strange, but I love them. You know, I've realized at one point in time that I am transatlantic.
Oh?
I was born in the wrong country. Every time I go to the United States, I'm like, oh, this is home. And then I come back here, I was like, this is a strange place.
Well,
but then, you know, I meet my old friends, like Eirik. This is you. And I'm like, oh, yeah, of course I'm here. I wouldn't meet Eirik if I went and grew up in the States.
Well,
then I meet your brother.
With me, it's different. I get more and more upset about what is going on in the United States.
Yeah, it's crazy. You know why? Because
yes.
I haven't gone there yet to set the record straight. They're waiting for the show.
Yes, you should do that.
The moment
the
WakeUp Show comes
job.
To the US,
it's quite a job.
You'll see how it sort of just balances out.
For instance, my brother, who's been living there now 40 years, he said he's against the trade unions. And that is very American.
Yeah.
Because it is destroying the business or something like that. You know?
Don't want people to organize and have rights. No, that's horrible. Yeah, that is strange.
There's so many poor people in the United States.
Yeah.
So many who are, what do you call them? Homeless people. So many homeless people.
Yeah.
Per thousand or per million, I think there are 10 times as many poor people in the United States than there are in Norway. At least 10 times.
Yes. Well, we did not come here to fix their problems.
No, not yet.
Yes, this is true.
Not yet.
When I was thinking about karma, which was the word that came to us, the word reincarnation also came to mind.
Yes, of course.
Of course. And you know, Eirik, when I'm wondering about something, what do I like to do? I walk out into the dream and I ask my fellow citizens about that question, you know. I ask them about reincarnation. Do you believe in reincarnation?
No.
Why not?
No, I believe in souls, not reincarnation, no.
Souls. Tell me more about this soul concept you believe in. Do you believe in reincarnation?
I believe that the soul is going further after the death.
This is not the end of the line.
Yeah.
I believe in the concept, but... since like I've never really seen it with my eyes, it's gonna be hard for me to believe. But I believe in the concept though, because like I believe that there ain't no new souls. So basically the ones that die come back.
Yeah.
In a way. But since it's still not proven, I can't really say, yeah, I'm a true believer.
I believe in souls. Like when you die, our souls go to certain place.
But not this place.
Not this place.
We've been here now.
Bodies go down. If you bury it, yeah, body go down. But your soul meets. I believe in soul.
Oh yeah, but in like a heaven type?
No, not heaven. It's a different dimension.
Dimensions. Mm-hmm. I like where you're going with this. Do you believe in reincarnation?
Yes, I believe.
Would you care to, like, why?
Because if you come, you're born to this life and you have a lesson to learn, and if you don't get to learn the lesson, you will don't.
Repeat the cycle.
Yeah.
Ooh. Is there like an end to it all? I guess the Hindus call it nirvana or something, or is it just an ever-going cycle?
Well, when if I die, I want to come back, so I'm going to go by the ever-going cycle. So,
yeah. Do you have any idea where the soul is heading off to?
No, no clue actually, no. I think it's... maybe you can call it something where everything comes from. It's going
source.
Back to, yeah, something like that, maybe. I don't know. Yeah.
Well, I guess that's the mystery, isn't it?
Yes.
And that's what all religions try to sort of unwrap or put words to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But if you see, I've seen some dead people, and if you see that a person, you see that it's nothing left of the person. It's only that, like the.
It's just a shell.
Yeah. So it's very easy to see that. So you know that he or she is gone.
The soul.
Yeah, the soul is gone.
The soul.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we are all the time, like in spiritual world, is around us all the time, but they are in different dimension.
Oh yeah, that's cool. Mm. So everyone's here, but in different realities or dimensions.
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I guess if you know it.
Because some people can sense them, and others can't. Most normal,
that's
is,
true.
No?
Yeah. How many times could we repeat this cycle? And what happens when we've learned it?
Oh, it's a big question. I don't know, maybe if you learn it, it will, it's peace and, I don't know.
Is that what the Christian people call heaven on earth or something like that? Because then we're sort of, okay, we're cool. I don't know. It's interesting.
Yeah, reflect on this, if you fulfilling the...
your task or your purpose. Yeah. Or like the Hindus, I guess, call it Nirvana.
Yeah, Nirvana, yeah.
Yeah. Hmm. It's also a band.
Okay.
Yes. How about you? Do you believe in reincarnation? That's a yes, no answer.
So. I don't know.
You were født på nytt, hvis du ikke lærer det.
Yeah. Maybe.
Maybe. Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah.
But I think it's you can choose to believe or not believe. I mean,
yes.
And the people that are normally very... like to have answers and 1 + 1 = 2, etc. They will never believe. But if you're a little bit more, and of course when you're younger, you're even more so, but after been living some years, maybe you can see that this, maybe something else. When you was around 20, it was maybe very like, now it's impossible. I'm talking about my ex actually, he was very like that. But no, and he's like a mathematician, so. But I think he's a little bit.
It's opened up a bit to the possibility of a magical reality.
Yeah, not a magical, but maybe. But we are different, so. That's good to know. Yeah, but now I have to run.
You have to go to your appointment. Yeah. Thank you so much for your time. We are the Wake Up Show every Thursday, which is tonight at 10 p.m. on Facebook. Check us out. Thank you.
So that was Dreamers about reincarnation, which is like lives just over and over again.
Yes.
But what is reincarnation, Eric?
It is getting a new body. The thing is, you're supposed to learn. You're supposed to learn in this life to be doing only right and good things, yes?
Yeah.
To be love incarnated, yes?
Yes, yes.
But since we need so much time to learn our lecture,
yes,
our body is getting older and you're not really functioning well. So the soul says, let's get a new body.
We'll just have another go at it.
Yeah, we have another go at it. And hopefully, in your next life, you're a little bit further advanced. And then it continues until you have reached the level where you radiate love, only love. It takes quite a few incarnations because you're... No, I can't do this, I cannot do this, and you know. Wow.
And this is what the Hindus call nirvana?
Nirvana. Yes, you go to nirvana.
Yes. And that it's what Americans call McDonald's? That's a joke.
It's a good joke.
I could brain needs work. I agree. And here, you know, the video game analogy comes in. Because that's a video game. Oh. You go to level. But my point being that it makes no sense. I know you have a train to catch. That's
yes.
pretty important, right?
Yes, and I think we should...
We should wrap it up.
Yeah.
But this conversation needs to continue. For one thing, you have to invite me to your place and you have to ask me and teach me TM. I'm looking forward to that. Is that something we can do?
Yes, but not immediately. There's certain...
So Saturday then? I'm kidding. It's a joke.
I'm looking forward.
Now, I have to do something which is, at the end of each episode, I search the internet. You know about the internet, even though you don't know about video games. I'm joking. For a quote that I find works well with tonight's episode. Now, I've searched the internet, actually, and I found a quote. And I was wondering, Eric, would you be so kind as to read this quote to this camera over there with the red light? This one. Would that be okay? This one.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself, then make a change. Michael Jackson. Oh, Michael Jackson was a wonderful man.
Yeah, but as are you.
I have to go.
You have to go. I will not be able to do the song thing.
No.
I'll leave that for later then. How are we on time?
22:49.
I like this. You have to go.
Yeah.
I will walk you out. I will just say goodbye to our viewers. Will you also say goodbye to the viewers?
To?
The viewers, you know, the people who's watching
the show. Oh, yes, come on. Otherwise, I don't want to...
You're not going to miss the train. Beloved viewers, thank you so much for watching the show. Turns out that my guest has to catch the train, you know, and that's important. And I want to say, Eric, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you.
And Eric, from the bottom of my heart, which is bottomless, by the way, I love you, man.
Thank you.
And I look forward to next time hanging out. And then, I love everyone. I love you, Markus.
Yeah, then it tells me you're on the track.
We are on the track, man.
Yes,
and now we're going to go to the train track. Run the outro clip. And